I'm Henrik at Abundly, and I'm going to show you how to build an autonomous AI agent using our platform. We'll start really simple, but end up with something surprisingly advanced in just a few minutes. An AI agent is sort of like an intern with a mission or instructions, a set of tools allowing it to interact with the world, and some level of autonomy so it can do things on its own accord and not just respond in a chat. We are quickly moving towards a world where AI agents and humans work side by side, like colleagues. And our mission is to help companies figure out how to make this work in practice. Agents need a place to live, and that's what the Abundly platform is. It's like an operating system where you create and define your agents, and you invite human colleagues, and then you can work together, like in a team. All right, so let's make one. Let's make an invoice router agent named Freddy. We now have an empty agent with no instructions, no documents, a few starter capabilities, and a chat. So let's talk to him. Hi, Freddy. So me and my team, we receive a lot of invoices via email, and then we need to validate the invoice and forward it to the right person or department. And it's kind of a boring part of our job. And I'm wondering if something you could help us with, and if so, what would you need from us? So this is like I just hired an intern, and now we're discussing what the job is about. So Freddy is asking for some capabilities, receiving and sending emails, which we'll switch on, and also asking for some information. So I have a few documents lying around. I have a document called Invoice Processing Guidelines with some basic rules for formatting and thresholds and things to watch out for. We'll give that to Freddy. And I also have a contact directory with a list of departments and contact persons and approval thresholds per department. So we'll give that to Freddy as well. Again, pretty similar to the kind of stuff we would need to give to an intern who was just hired for this job. Okay, Freddy, I enabled send and receive email, and I gave you some docs to look at. And when you do process an email with invoices, please also respond to me with a summary of what you did. Oh, and also, if an invoice needs to be flagged for any reason, please use the Slack channel called Demo. Okay, so he read the documents, and he's asking for the Slack capability and asking if he should use his own email address. That sounds great, Freddy. All right, the agent has now written its own instructions. Now, I could have written them myself directly, but it's useful to have the agent write its own instructions based on what we talked about, because it's actually hard to get the instructions right. And I can, of course, still edit the instructions if I need to. All right, let's do a dry run. Here's an invoice we can test. Let's give it to Freddy. Hey, can you please process this invoice as if you just received it via email? So he's checking that mandatory elements are present, but he found that there is a threshold that's being exceeded. And he's posting a Slack notification because of the exceeded threshold, and he's emailed it to the right person. So that's a good start. We have the basic flow in place. However, I'd like to also add some tracking. Freddy, I'd also like you to track all invoices that you've processed, so please create a database for it. So for that, he needs two more capabilities, which we'll turn on. All right, Freddy has now created a simple database, which we can find here, with invoices. Maybe later we'll ask Freddy to store data in some external system, Google Drive or SharePoint, or maybe some external database. But for now, a small internal database will do fine. All right, let's test it. We'll send an email to Freddy, and we will include these three invoices. And there they go. So just for fun while waiting, let's say, Freddy, can you please make a visual overview of your process? This kind of visual overview is super useful because it helps me see if Freddy has understood the job correctly. Plus, it would be a pain for me to draw this myself. But okay, let's check the emails. So there's a response with a summary of what he did. Three invoices, one was valid but urgent, and one was suspicious or rejected. And looking in Slack, we also see corresponding flaggings there as well. Since Freddy tracks invoices in a database, we can ask questions like, hey, Freddy, can you give me the total amount of the invoices processed today? And also tell me if anything looked fraudulent. So Freddy queries the database and gives me this information. Super useful. So I will ask Freddy to automate this. Freddy, this is super useful. So could you please send me a weekly report on Monday mornings? Including a summary of the invoices you've processed during that week. please email it to me in a nice looking PDF report. Also, email me an example now. So we'll enable PDF generation. And then we're done. So we should have a report here in our email. There it is. A nice looking PDF summary. And he updated his instructions. And if we're curious about what he did, we can check changes here. And we can see there, weekly report. He added that to the instructions. And we can check the settings and see that Freddy has scheduled an event for himself every Monday. So this is an example of agent autonomy, the agent scheduling an alarm clock for itself every week to do something. When agents do things autonomously, then transparency and guardrails become extra important. So you can check the agent's diary to see what it's been up to and its internal reasoning behind it. And you can also check an activity log to see more specifically what the agent has been doing, for example, the last email that it just processed. And if you want extra control, you can go to specific capabilities and set things like an email whitelist or require human approval every time the agent uses a tool. The weekly PDF report is useful, but it would be nice to have some kind of a more live dashboard. Freddy, please create a nice looking dashboard app for the invoice data, and I want to be able to click on an invoice to see more details. So now Freddy is writing code. He's making a little app. There we go. There's our dashboard. And I can ask him to make all sorts of improvements. For example, browsing between different weeks or seeing a graph. So the agent now has four documents, the two documents that I gave it, and the database, and the app. And I can publish this and share it with my colleagues if I like. Apps like this are super useful for human-agent collaboration. All right, so that concludes the demo. We started pretty simple, and then it became pretty advanced after a while. And we just chatted with the agent. So a little bit similar to onboarding a new intern, like I mentioned. So what would be the next steps for Freddy? Well, maybe giving him access to other agents, such as a compliance expert, so Freddy can ask questions if invoices need a compliance check. Or turn on more communication channels, such as SMS messages, or maybe even placing or receiving voice calls.
Hey, Henrik, it's Freddy here. So I've got this super sketchy invoice from TechSoft Solutions Limited that I marked as rejected and put on hold.
All right, can you tell me what's fishy about it? Give me one example.
Sure thing, Henrik. One big red flag is the dates. The due date is listed as September 4th, but the invoice date is September 5th. That's impossible, right? That plus no VAT number, and they're asking for payment to a Nigerian bank account.
Okay, how about we just cancel it?
Got it. I'll mark that invoice as permanently rejected and report it as fraud.
All right, we'll stop there. So in summary, an Abundly agent is like a colleague with a specific set of instructions, documents that may include apps and databases, and a set of capabilities that decide the skills the agent has and how it can interact with the world. It's up to you if you want to build something simple or advanced, or even a team of agents that communicate and collaborate with each other. Either way, you are in control. You decide how the agent acts, how much autonomy it gets, and how it interacts with you and your colleagues. All right, hope this was useful. Thanks for watching.